I remember our first emergency. I had to rush my husband to the hospital because he had kidney stones. I know. And like I had heard a while back, somebody told me the most pain a man can ever feel is kidney stones, right? So like I'm trying to keep that thought in my mind as I'm looking at my husband who is like hunched over in pain, moaning, groaning, crying a little bit. Because I'll be honest, you guys, there were a couple times where I did think to myself like, you need to man up. Right, because my husband, he's over here like, oh, baby hurts, and I'm just like, babe, what's wrong? What's it feel like? Like a cramp? Is it like a period? Oh, you want me to take you to the hospital? You're funny. Just grab the heating pad. Ladies, I tried to tell him just curl up in a ball and rock back and forth. It didn't work. And the thing was, we were about to go to bed, right? And I wasn't feeling well, so I had just taken NyQuil. So I'm trying to rush my husband to the hospital, dozing at the wheel. By the time we get there, he's dying in pain. I'm intoxicated. The doctor's trying to communicate with us, like, whoa, what's going on here? Who drove you guys here? And I was just like, Your Honor. Can I say something? I drove us guys here. But having this use, I'm on NyQuil. He's just a baby. So they admitted us both. It's pretty expensive.
Share something with you, because sometimes, right, audiences will send me gifts. Like, not this audience. Honestly, sometimes audiences bring me gifts, and then they give it to the usher, and the usher will bring it backstage, and then I have to open it, because I don't have a crew of people that travel with me, because I'm not Adele. You know, I don't know how people imagine, like, I walked here tonight, the five blocks. You know, when you make that decision, you go, it's only five blocks, I'm gonna walk it. And then after the third block, you go, fuck, I should have taken an Uber. Then you go, it's too late now, I can't get an Uber now for two blocks because I think I'm lazy. You don't want them to give you a two-star because you're lazy, because then you have to fake a limp and stuff. Yeah, I just sprained my ankle. So I get this gift, right? I do a show in Auckland and a woman sends a gift with an usher and the usher brings it to the room. And now I'm gonna open it, but it looked dodgy as hell. It was just wrapped in brown paper and it had a string around it. And not that fancy string that you get now over Christmas, you know, you always get your, like your sister-in-law, she'll be doing all this fancy fucking wrapping and shit. And you go, okay, calm down, Monya. We know it's bath salts. Holy Christ, you just spent $45 on the wrapping of a $2 fucking gift. And we don't have a bath. Not one of those strings. It was just an old shoelace. So, you know, when it's dodgy, when the usher sort of kicks the door open, throws the gift, and I go, that can't fit you, and runs away. So I look at this gift, and I shook it, and no powder fell out of it, and it wasn't ticking. So I'm going to open it. So I opened the gift, and someone had sent me a moon cup. Like a new one, but a moon cup. Now, for those of you who don't know what a moon cup is, ladies, if I can ask you to just turn to the men in your area and just explain to them what a moon cup is so I don't have to. Talk amongst yourselves. If you don't know, ask the people behind you. They know. Oh, I don't know what's going on there. There's a lady in the back doing that. Explaining, but I think you're doing it wrong. For those of you who don't know what a moon cup is, it's basically a Tupperware bowl for your kuchacha. Like you whip it out when Aunt Flo comes to visit, you feel? But I knew as soon as I received this gift, I knew I was in deep trouble because I've got an inquiring mind and I knew I was going to try it. Now, I'm not going to go into detail, but let me just tell you, it's not for me. Let's just say, okay, you know when you're unpacking the dishwasher, right? Ladies, if you want to turn to the men in your area and just explain what I mean. Now, you know when you're unpacking the dishwasher and you get to the kids' plastic bowls and cups and you don't take the time to individually dry each and every cup. You just kind of grab them, whack them and stack them away, and then tomorrow morning you have to feed those same children out of those bowls and you take it out and you're like... Yeah, that. So no, it's not for me.
For it. All the names for periods suck. Period, time of the month, Aunt Flo, they all suck. You know what we should call a period? A period should be called bloody tissue falling out of a hole. If you went into work and you were like, hey, I got bloody tissue falling out of a hole. Women know they're gross. We get it. There's never a time we wake up and we're like, oh, I'm so excited to clean up a crime scene. It does make you wonder, though. Are there more women who murder? We've just been so good at getting out blood. A skill we learned at age 11. Like, no one must know. Yeah, I clean out my vagina once a month. I think I can clean up a body twice a year. Periods are gross. I know they're gross. But I talk about them a lot because I want men to be more comfortable. But then, I was thinking how women, how we would act if men were the ones who got periods. And you know what? I don't think we would be very nice. I think as soon as a man got his period, we'd be like, get in the shed, Kevin! Kevin, get in the shed! No, you're very leaky! And when you're in the house, you're only on the linoleum. Don't you dare go in my living room. That is a new slip cover and you're very leaky. You're just like your father. Of course, women, I also think we'd have to participate a lot more in male periods, you know? Like, you know, women, we would have to be the ones to remind men to change their tampons. You know we would. We'd have to be like, when was the last time you changed your tampon? Babe. Oh, it was, oh, 3 years ago. But I took it out, I flipped it around, and I put it back in, so. Oh, no, little buddy. I think that's probably what male tampons would be called. Little buddy. Fun with this, like all the strings would have little superheroes on the ends. One would just have like Spider-Man shooting up a web. Another one's got Batman. It's like when Batman's face.